My goal in this video is to demonstrate beyond a reasonable doubt that I'm being hustled by murderers in public, masquerading as public officials in violation of Section 2340A of the United States Code, disallowing torture. These murderers have stalked me for 60 years and kept me in isolation, refused me property, family, education, all of which is against the law, while poisoning me repeatedly, leading to severe neurological injuries, tremors, deafness, glaucoma, gum disease, and other insidious, irreversible injuries. And these murderers continue to hold office and continue to masquerade as though they're not doing what they are doing. And they have sufficient licentiousness to control the hideaways of people like them, which include the Bar Association, the House of Representatives, and other forms of low life. You can see one of them right here with so braggart as to put his face right on top of my face in a Northwest Asian Weekly, a magazine that also braggarted that they were involved in the murder of Cersei Kennedy through a technique known as gaslighting. This is a form of federal encryption by a public official saying, I have taken notice of you and my fans are going to look shiningly and smilingly upon the covert bait that I dish out to you, queer ball. They lured me here with promises for protection from abuse, then promptly had me banned from college, where when I finally escaped 12 years later, I made honors and straight A's. And they never apologized. I was in homeless wreckage because of a man who was arrested for museum theft, who they supported by banning me from college, saying I was speaking of dignified people like that Jay Inslee dude. So they put me in a place called AdWas, which had Fridays off. AdWas the Walrus. AdWas stood for Abuse Deaf Women's Advocacy Service. After my deaf advocate was attacked and raped, but not given AIDS, these murderers who tortured me put out a book called Enough But Not Enough. In other words, they were like vampires who had enough blood but needed more. Now, take a look at what really motivated. They say at Sound Mental Health in Seattle Art Museum, Yoko Ono is going to, you know, get even for John Lennon on this dude. What Yoko Ono is really getting even with comes from 1948. Columbia Teachers College Bureau Publications, The Challenge of Atomic Energy by Rod Crowe and Israel Light. How's that for a CIA name? Israel Light, Gottlieb and Light. Gottlieb, the German name with the Israeli index name that led to Wattenmaker. That's what Krohag Regusa, I mean Yoko Ono, is really avenging. It's World War II's Hiroshima bombing. The Challenge of Atomic Energy was written by my father when he was there with Dwight Eisenhower, I've appeared in Sinise Film Quarterly, making me a souvenir child for the Licky Chops crowd around who Yoko Ono vowed that my father would never have a successful son, that my life would be one of torment and horror from the day I was born. She was behind planting the script on me that these brothers of evil have justified as allowing them to torture me, allowing them to violate my rights, to poison me, to keep me out of school, and then to laugh and call themselves friends. Take a look at this image I found in an Ayn Rand film with the caption, "It will be like starting over." It will be like starting over. See how she has her hands? See, these people trace back to Diaghilev, the ballet dancer. So they use not just sign language, but they use body language that is ballet symbolic. Clasping hands over their ears from the Hiroshima blast. And she looks like Gail Burston. That's how she makes her eyes a little Asiatic there. The name on the script, "It will be just like starting over." And they forced me, kneeling and scraping in seizures, to take a train while my rectum was passing enormous amounts of gas from one of the horrible poisons that they administrated to me. In utter humiliation, and to go to the Dakota and plead apology to the Crow CAG reducer for something that never even happened. They were playing this game back when they did the trial run, and it was all dreamed up by the Italian Fascist Cinema Guild behind the script by Gail Burston. The Invention of Life was the name of one of their gurus, a book about one of their gurus. This is the invention of life. In other words, just convince people that John Lennon died and you can use his name. And it was all in their cinema build up to the case. "He did see you." "No, he thinks I'm dead." "He thinks I'm dead." "He did see you." "He thinks I'm dead." So much happens these days. So much does not. So much happens these days. So much does not. They played this double game. And the real motive behind the attacks by Penis Inslee and Yoko Gorogor and the obfuscation of the Bar Association and the NAACP, who are licky chops with glee, that they got over on with this counterfeiting. A counterfeiting of a whole society's idea of reality, which they mask behind denials that they're not really playing this game. The birthplace of fascism was also a notorious den for counterfeiting in Italian fascist cinema. The real motive in this is to get even for Hiroshima. That's the real motive. Jay Inslee has authored a threat to blow up his own society, the society his children live in and go to school, to appease the spinner beanies of Cornell West, Yoko Ono, and Columbia, who are dead set on ravaging me. That's their minds are caked with hatred for the idea of a little white boy who tried to go to school even after he was deaf. It drives them crazy. They throw themselves on the floor and rip the carpet to shreds. They practice yoga and learn jaws so that they can more easily chew at the carpet that they rip to shreds at the idea of a little white boy who wanted to go to school even though he was deaf. It drives Cornel West berserk. He throws himself to the floor and rips the cards into shreds. Jay Inslee goes bananas at the idea of it. The idea that a person's hard work would be compensated. Instead, he poisons you in the mouth. And he gives you Parkinson's disease. And he gaslights you through the newspapers. It says public officials just do that. What, that's what you get for speaking out against Hitler, Reagan.